Reed Instruments dual moisture meter. I was gonna open it up, give it a try today, see how this thing works. I teach high school woodshop and we mill our own lumber. We're currently making cutting boards. So let's see how this thing works. Uh-oh, gotta go quick, bell just rang. Hopefully it has its own battery. Yep. Well, that's cool. So there's the battery. Okay, I watched their video. I think I'll add a few more pieces to their video as well. So it's a Reed dual moisture meter. This is power on. It'll hold it a little bit, it'll turn on. I like how you have to hold it to turn it on, and then if no buttons are pushed after a while, it'll turn off automatically, so that's really nice as well. These prongs right here, this comes off, and there are the prongs. This could do both building materials and just wood for woodworking. It could do it with both the prongs and a sensor in the back. So I know it's kind of small here, but right there, that little log right there is saying prongs for wood material. I hit mode. That's saying building materials with prongs. I hit mode again. Flashing log is saying it's using the pinless sensor on the back. So my desk has about 13% moisture in it. So it's using the pinless sensor in the back when it's flashing. And then the fourth mode is flashing bricks, and that's pinless building materials. So actually my desk is about 6% moisture. So that's the mode. We're primarily going to use it in just a pin wood mode for the high school wood shop, just so kids kind of understand how moisture on wood really works. And then this button right here is a lock feature, and also you could turn on the beeper on and off. That right here is battery power, and that right there is the beeper's on. So this protective covering on here is kind of cool too. You could just take it off, drop it in there and test that the thing's working. And then if you look on there, those three things is telling you that it's a big number. So if you had one little drop, low moisture, two little water drops, medium moisture, and then three drops, a lot of moisture. So that's an overview. Let's go out into the shop and see how it goes. I bet we'll be all over the place with moisture since we mill our own lumber. So let's go take a look. Here we are in the woodworking shop. Let's give it a test. This is an old piece of cypress wood. The log's been in the yard for quite a while. It's pretty dead. And then we'll put the Reed moisture meter on woodworking, prong woodworking, and cycle through there. And I think that's about 11%. So that's pretty low moisture because that log's been laying around for a long time before we milled it. Here's a cedar board we just milled pretty recently. That was at 15 or 16%. That board right there is the same, 16%. Here's an old piece of oak. I think that's at about 11%. So kind of all over the place for moisture in our different lumber. Here I'm trying it out as a construction tool. So I'm in the pinless mode there, flashing bricks. So, and it's in the construction mode. So the wall has about 5% moisture in it. That's good to know that it's no rot behind that sheetrock. 5% is pretty low moisture. We're moving it around, checking in different spots, and staying pretty consistent at 5%. Here's a river style table the student's making, filled with epoxy. So I'm going to go from the construction mode to the, I think, pinless. So there's regular wood, regular construction, now pinless wood. I'll just put it down there. And this is a piece of Dawn Redwood. We milled this a long time ago, and it was dry to start with about 8% moisture. Here's a cedar table. 25%, three drops, a lot of moisture. We're going to get a lot of checking out of that. What we should have done is paint this anchor seal over the end grain, and that makes the moisture evaporate slower, so the wood warps less and checks less. So that anchor seal is a cool product, but you got to put it on there for it to work. Okay, here we are out back. This is the mill. It's a wood-mizer mill. I love this thing, coolest mill ever. There's an oak log and a cedar log. I do tree work on the weekends, bring the logs in, and then the students mill out the lumber and we stack it here. And then we build cool projects out of this wood. So this cedar log right here at the core here is 6%, pretty low moisture in the center of it. And then on the outside, really high moisture. That might actually be more due to rainwater soaking in there than the actual moisture of the tree. And kind of interesting. Actually, it's really interesting. Maybe I'll keep checking that and see if that rainwater evaporates out quickly. Some of the cedar boards, incense cedar boards we've milled just pretty recently. Yeah, high moisture, 24%. It's a old cedar tree as well. Lightning struck cedar, super cool.